Northeast people living in Delhi have not only received relief ration from Delhi police and NGOs during the lockdown period, but have also contributed rations which have been distributed among the needy, including non-Northeasterners and migrant workers also. NGO Helping Hands, founded by Delhi Police's Special Commissioner Robin Hibbu, as also Delhi Police personnel, have been in the forefront of this collection from generous donors in Delhi and distribution to the needy.
The Northeast people have helped the Helping Hand during this COVID lockdown in Delhi and NCR. In the initial stage, we somehow pulled our resources from our own source and we started distributing rations to our own people. Later on, when it was exhausted, I had appealed to the Northeast people to donate or to give the essential commodities to our poor Northeast people. It was a massive response from all part of the Northeast, and most of the almost 127 people, they came out and gave all those help to poor rations for the Northeast people.
Every day, the team prepares a list of needy people who are facing financial or other difficulties in buying their rations in Delhi, takes stock of the rations at hand, calls the needy people to come to a fixed venue and ferries the rations there for distribution. Recently, one such drive was carried out among Burmese refugees living in the national capital. Our team of Youthfolio witnessed a methodical approach of refugees making a queue, following social distancing and wearing masks, and police personnel distributing rice, pulses, atta, biscuits, soap, etc. Helping Hands, with the help of Delhi Police, had distributed food and other items to over 6,623 families till the 5th of June.
Till now, we have given 6,623 families. We have provided the ration to 6,623 families. 6,623 families. And still, we are having some more materials with us and the process is still continuous. Initially, some friends and other donors provided us. Thereafter, Northeast Council also came in front and they also provided about 25 tons of rice and 6 to 7 ton of dal etc. Along with others, they provided soap, sanitary pads, and shampoo pouches, etc.
The Burmese people who received rations expressed gratitude for the same, saying that they were facing tremendous difficulties due to corona pandemic and lockdown.
लॉकडाउन की वजह से हम लोग ये बर्मीज लोग बहुत तकलीफ में रह रहे हैं और हमारे पास खाना वगैरह वगैरह बहुत वो हो रहा है, तकलीफ होता है और ये लॉकडाउन की वजह से हमारा हम लोग को बहुत दिक्कत होता है और वैसे ये लोग ने हम लोग हेल्पिंग किया तो हम लोग बहुत कुछ रह पाते हैं और मतलब बहुत वो होता है, बहुत बहुत खुशी होते हैं इन लोग से मरने के लिए.
We have been facing a lot of crisis during the pandemic, so we are very helpful to everyone who's helping out at the NGO. And it somehow helps, even as a little bit, it somehow helps us.
Apart from rations, Helping Hands is also providing legal, medical, psychological, investment and other help.
Call up our notice helpline number 1093 plus for anything for rations or anything other help. Even we have other helpline also, like we have a legal teams to give legal assistance to our notice stranded people. Some cases like landlord trying to evict them forcefully. We have many cases of our employees working in the private sectors, their salaries were not given. So all these are the legal teams were willing. We had a full legal team available to help them out. Then we have a what is called advisor even for the medical team. One is for Delhi, another is for all India. Even for the we have 8 medical teams for ladies as well as for the gents, because many a time now the whole focus of the all the hospitals are on the COVID virus. As a result, many a time our people, many of them, they can't speak proper Hindi, they're not able to get the whole attention. So as a result, you know, all this phobia of everything, even a small ailment to be a COVID, has put us into a grave challenge. So we have even we have a medical help, what is called assistance 24/7, including four ladies. Then we have a distress counseling helpline. We found, well, unfortunately, even one boy committed suicide in Agra, even in many other places. A lot of people were expressing a lot of stress and, you know, disoriented, and they really need to be counseled. So we have two counselors from Delhi who have volunteered, and we have counseled many of our youth who wanted to have a conversation and counsel them, give them a hope. And apart from that, even we have a investment advisor, because during this lockdown, our many small time what is called entrepreneur or businessmen from Northeast have almost, you know, have tossed upside down. I mean to say, their business has completely gone to a, you know, in a loss.